सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने ओमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणुजाति पुरो वेदागश्च प्रभिणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेवात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशमुमुक्षुरो शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽहं शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नाय अन्तिक संसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे जस्ट क्लारिफिकेशन विद दि अर्लियर मंत्र फ्रॉम बृहत् तेन इति ब्रह्मवित् पुण्यकृत् तैजसश्च सो हियर आई चेक्ड अप दि भाष्य even bhashya is not so clear to me, so I had to see the tika, whereby there is some clarification there as to, just give me a moment, I made a note but I seem to have closed the document. Okay, so this tena is explained as brahmajna ब्रह्मज्ञानं मार्गेण सो दि ज्ञानमार्गेण सो दि तेन एति सो दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड एति वी हैव सीन गच्छति बट दि गमन कैन नॉट बी देयर फॉर दि ब्रह्मज्ञानी सो उपासना कैन बी कंसिडर्ड बट देन दि मार्ग देयर इन दि मंत्र सम श्वेत इत्यादि सम कलर्स आर मेंशन्ड सो सम कॉल दिस एज ऑफ दिस कलर एंड ऑफ दैट कलर सो सम पाथ इज डिस्कस्ड देयर सो देर दि टीकाकार से तेन ज्ञान मार्गेण ब्रह्मविद एति गच्छति मीनिंग वॉट ब्रह्म प्राप्नोति सो इफ यू टेक इट लिटरली इट वुड अप्लाई टू अ ब्रह्म ज्ञानी हु इज एन उपासक बट सिंस द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज ऑफ ज्ञान ब्रह्म ज्ञान इट कैन बी टेकन एज वन हु डिड नॉट गेट जीवन मुक्ति बट क्रम मुक्ति दैट्स वन पॉसिबिलिटी और इट इज जस्ट एन अर्थवाद एज इन देर इज नो रियल गमन बट द प्राप्ति इज प्राप्त से प्राप्ति सो प्राप्नोति ज्ञानेन स्वरूप लक्षण ब्रह्म प्राप्नोति दिस कैन बी द अंडरस्टैंडिंग देर एज वन अटेन्स वन्स ओन स्वरूप सो देर गच्छति मीन्स प्राप्नोति एंड इट इज प्राप्त से प्राप्ति देर इज नो रियल अटेनमेंट देर इज नो रियल गमन ऑल्सो इट कैन बी मुख्य ब्रह्म ज्ञान बट देन पुण्यकृत हैज बीन मेंशन सो तेन एति सो दिस ब्रह्मविथ वन हु ब्रह्म वेत्ति ब्रह्मविथ वन हु नोज ब्रह्म इज ब्रह्मविथ सो दिस ज्ञानी इज ऑल्सो इन सामानाधिकरण्य विथ पुण्यकृत मीनिंग ब्रह्मविथ इज इन सामानाधिकरण्यम विथ पुण्यकृत शब्द सो पुण्यकृत एंड देन तैजसश्च दिस तैजसश्च आई सेड दैट इट इज नॉट रियली इंपॉर्टेंट देयर But if you look at the Bhashya and the Tika explains that Tejasa is Tejasi. Tejasi Vartate Iti Tejasaha. So this Brahmavit himself is called as Tejasaha. So Tejasa Yutpatti is Tadhita as in Tejasi Vartate. One who is in Tejas. And Tejas is explained by Bhagavan Tikakara as Paramatmani. Atmatvena. So one who remains in Tejas. In the Prakasha Swarupa of Atma, Jnana Swarupa, Prakasha means Jnana Swarupa, Tejas means Prakasha. And in Jnana Swarupa one remains, Prakasha is Jnana and in that Chaitanya Swarupa one remains, Paramatmani. How? Atmatvena, as oneself. So thereby, Tejasa is a clincher to show that Brahmavit is in its Mukhya meaning also. And Punyakrut is the focus here really. Because otherwise, if you look at the Bhashya also without the Tika, there is no possibility of understanding this Ataha Jayastvam. This Jayastva cannot be understood at all as to how this Brahma Sutra with this Vishaya Mantra as Tene Iti Brahmavit Punyakrut Taijasascha, how it is showing the superiority of the Ashrami Karma and Ashramitva being superior to Anashramitva for Jnana Sadhana. Just Ashramitvam is superior to Anashramitvam is not an issue. It can be quoted, but it can be established by any quotation of similar Shruti. But how, as a Jnana Sadhana, this Ashramitva is superior cannot be understood unless we see this Brahmavitvam is Jnanena Brahma Prapti in that context, and Punyakrut as explained in the Tika, because Bhagavan Tikakara there says the explanation for Punyakrut is Punyakrut is such a Punyam Swashramoktam Karma Karoti Iti Punyakrut Uchyate. So who is this Punyakrut? This Brahmavit who is Punyakrut? And the Bhashya there says that it does not mean that one is doing Punya Karma. This Punyakrut shows that one is doing Punya. And Bhagavan Tikakara says he does Swashrama Karma. So if you take it in Vartamana Kala, as in Punyam, the Upapada Tatpurusha as Punyam Karoti Iti Punyakrut, which is the Vyutpatti of the Punyakrut Shabda, the Krudanta Vyutpatti. However, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it is an impossibility for all the various reasons we have seen, due to all sorts of Virodhas in all aspects. Therefore, Brahmavit cannot be doing Punya Karma also, because Punya is like Papa itself, it is equivalent, because Karma will generate further gati, samsara. And due to Virodha, this Brahmavit is not doing Punya Karma also. Therefore, this Punyakrut should be seen in Bhutakala, says the Bhashya there. However, this Taijasascha and Punyakrut put together, Taijasascha and Brahmavit put together shows the Jnani. And Punyakrut shows that there is Ashrama Karma. So Punyam meaning Swashrama Uktam Karma Karoti. Varnashrama Dharma is being followed. Thereby, one who has done this Ashrama Karma, whereby one has got Chitta Shuddhi, whereby the Jnanotpatti was possible, whereby he became Brahmavit and Taijasa in the Paramatma Tejas Swarupa Paramatma, one has Atma Bhava, Atmatvam, and thereby he remains as Brahmavit Jnani. This is the meaning, and this is the reason how the Ashrama Karma, being an Ashrami, and Ashrama Karma as Jnana Sadhana is superior to being an Anashrami using the Anashrama Dharma, meaning Japa, Japa, Devata Aradhana, Upavasa Ityadi, which was mentioned earlier. As to Japa, Upavasa, Devata Aradhana, Ityadi. This is how the Sutra is established, because this was not really very clear yesterday. I couldn't do much justice, so I thought I should revisit this. I hope this is clear now. And thereby, Shruto Brahmavitva Visheshana Rupa Shruti Lingaccha. And this Chakara Shruti Lingaccha can be read, this Cha can be read with in continuation with the earlier sutra where it is established, something is established, and in continuation. So this and can be read together in continuation with the earlier sutra, or it can be as per the Bhashya where Bhagavan Bhashyakara says Shruti Lingat and Smriti Lingat. So Smriti Linga also he gives, where he says Anashramina Tishtheta Dinam Ekam Api Dvijaha Samvatsaram Anashrami Stitva Krucharam Ekam Charet Iti Cha Smriti Lingat. So this Chakara can be read with Smriti Linga also. He quotes that one should not remain Anashrami even for a single day. Who is that? Dvijaha. One who is a Dvija should not remain without an ashrama, so one should get married or remain in the Gurukula as Antevasi and become a Naishtika Brahmachari. So between ashramas also one should not be. So after the death of the wife, if one is not going to get remarried, then one should move to Sannyasa, Varnashrama or Vanaprastha or Sannyasa, preferably sannyasa. This is the idea there, as to between ashramas also one should not remain. And if one has remained for even 1 year, then one has to do one krichra prayaschitta. This is the smriti that he quotes. So since I couldn't do justice to this, I hope I could do more justice to it with the Bhashya and Tika. Thereby 3439 and the Adhikarana is also over. Now the next Adhikarana is Tad Bhuta Adhikaranam. So there was some typo, so I took a while to correct the document also. So the Tad Bhuta Adhikaranam is introduced in the Vritti as Purva Yatha Anashraminam Karmanaha Vidya Haitutva Muktam. How earlier in the prior Adhikarana, what was mentioned? The karma is Vidya Haitu. Which karma? Anashrami karma also. Anashrami karma, one who does not belong to the ashrama, fourfold ashrama, that sadhaka, even those people, anashramanam karma, their karma is also what? Hetu for vidya, brahma vidya. Tatha uttama ashramat purva ashramam praptasya karmanam vidya hetu to mastu iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. So taking cue from that, what Siddhanti has established, Purvapakshi says that similarly, let there be Brahma Vidya Sadhanatva. Hetutva means the sadhana for Brahma Vidya. Let there be for what? For the karmas. Which karma? He says the karma of one who has come back from the senior ashram to the junior ashram. And what does it mean really? One who has gone to Grahastha ashrama cannot come back to Brahmacharya. It is an impossibility, because being a Grahastha, just because you know one gives up the wedded life does not mean, married life does not mean that he will become a Brahmachari. So that is not possible. So what is being indicated here? One returning from the Vanaprastha and specifically returning from Sannyasa to the Grahastha ashrama, or if one is not married also, then giving up clothes and becoming a Brahmachari. Not becoming Atyashrami, but one going from the Sannyasa ashrama to Grahastha ashrama, or basically a fall from Prachyuti from Sannyasa ashrama. One indulging in the opposite gender, with the opposite gender, which is a fall from the Sannyasa ashrama. So even if one does not get married, giving up the Sannyasa ashrama, comes back to relations, not back, who has never had a relation or had a relation also, comes back, had a Grahastha ashrama, and from Grahastha ashrama one has gone to Sannyasa, he comes back to Grahastha ashrama, or gets involved with opposite gender, whether he was married earlier or not, whether he had a Purvashrama or not. So this is what the Purvapakshi says, that let that person's patita, one who is patita, one who has fallen, one who has prachyuti from Sannyasa ashrama, let his karma, which karma? If he becomes a Grahastha, then Grahastha karma, ashrama karma, or he becomes a Brahmachari, then his Agnikarya or Sandhyavandana ityadi, all of that let it become sadhana for Brahma Vidya Utpatti. This is the Purvapaksha Drishtanta there. And then he says, oh, this is similar, why not consider so? Thereby Tadbhuta Adhikaranam comes up, and the Sutrakara says, तद्भूतस्युत नातद्भावो जैमिनेरपि नियमा तद्रूपाभावेभ्यः तद्भूतस्युत नातद्भावो जैमिनेरपि नियमा तद्रूपाभावेभ्यः. सो तद्भूतस्य तु न अतद्भावः जैमिनेः अपि नियमा अतद्रूपाभावेभ्यः. इट्स अ सिंगल वर्ड, नियमा तद्रूपाभावेभ्यः. इट्स अ प्लूरल पंचमी बहुवचन. सो देर आर एटलीस्ट थ्री हेतुस, देर आर थ्री हेतुस, नियम अतद्रूप एंड अभाव. ड्यू टू नियम, दैट व्हाट इज द नियम? जैमिनी अपि. सो इवन जैमिनी आचार्य सेड, अपि अपि मीन्स दैट इवन जैमिनी सेज, मीनिंग एनीवे बादारण आचार्य, व्यासाचार्य सेज, वेदांति से, बट पूर्व मीमांसकाज ऑल्सो से दैट. व्हाट डू दे से? न अतद्भाव कस्य तद्भूतस्य. तद्भूतस्य मीन्स वन हु हैज ऑलरेडी अटेन्ड तद्भूत. तद्भूत इज यति सन्यास आश्रम प्राप्तस्य इत्यर्थः. सो सन्यास आत्र आश्रम प्राप्तस्य तद्भूतस्य यतेः तु हाउएवर वन हु हैज अटेन्ड सन्यास आश्रम दैट यति फॉर हिम व्हाट अतद्भावः नॉन सन्याश्रम नॉन यति भावः नास्ति न न भवति अयति त्वं न वन हु हैज बिकम अ सन्यासी ही शुड नेवर बिकम नॉन सन्यासी देयर इज नो रिटर्न इट्स अ सिंगल डायरेक्शनल इट्स अ वन वे death is the only result out of that meaning one can only move ahead into mrityu but one cannot come back there is no ashrama other than sanyasa ashrama for that person there is no reverse gear there is no coming back so one has to think over whether one is ready for sanyasa after taking sanyasa coming back is nishiddha should not be done there is no way in purva mimamsa and uttar mimamsa anyway says that one should not come back. So Jaimini Rapi, he also says, Jaimini Acharya, Purva Mimamsaka also says, and what is the hetu, why so? Shruti Niyama, Atadrupa, and Atadrupa Shruti also we can, Shruti Niyama, Atadrupa Shruti, there is no Shruti which talks about that, Shruti gives a Niyama, then there is no Shruti for Atadrupa, and what shishtachara abhavebhyah shishtachara is also shishtachara also does not allow it so the shishtas do not respect anyone any sanyasi it is the jyeshta ashrama sanyasa ashrama should be respected by all everyone falls at the feet of the sanyasi but those who have given up sanyasa ashrama nobody respects them There is no shishta who respects such sannyasis. So this is the hetu as a response to the Puropaksha. These are the hetus. Let's look at the vritti. I am speeding up because the content is not completely related to Vedanta. This sutra is definitely, this sutra is important. But then these are something which, you know, we don't need to spend a lot of time on. It is understood easily. There is nothing complex here. सो अत्र पूर्वपक्ष आश्रम ज्यायस्त्व असिद्धि नाउ पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट देर इज नथिंग लाइक अ ज्येष्ठ आश्रम संन्यास आश्रम इज नॉट अ ज्येष्ठ आश्रम सो देर फोर देर इज नो रिटर्न फ्रॉम अ हायर टू अ लोअर ही सेज दैट ऑल आश्रमस कैन बी सीन एज इक्वल वाई शुड यू सी संन्यास आश्रम एज सुपीरियर और ऑन अ हायर पेडेस्टल सो देर इज नो प्रच्युति देर इज नो फॉल Why do you think that there is a fall? One remains in one ashrama, moves to another ashrama. So one can remain in ashrama other than sannyasa ashrama, having taken that. There is no fall as you consider. This is what the Puropakshi is. So therefore, ashrama jayastva, superiority of ashrama, sannyasa ashrama is not established at all. Asiddhi. Siddhanti tat siddhir meaning ashrama jayastva siddhi iti phalabheda. Ashrama, sannyasa ashrama, there is a gradation in ashramas. In fact, brahmacharya, grahastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa, there is a gradation, hierarchy of ashramas. Brahmachari should respect the Grihastha. Who should respect the? Both should respect the Vanaprastha, one who is in Vanaprastha ashrama, and all three should respect Sannyasa. Sannyasa ashrama or Sannyasi, who is in that ashrama. And this is this sequence of what is superior to what, meaning Varnashrama dharma, Jnana. Jnana Jeshtatvam also, meaning Jnanat Vruddha, so Vruddha we say, Jnanena Vruddha, Vayasiva Vruddha, in age one is old or in through Jnana one becomes elder, so all these are gradations, then also Varnashrama, so Varnashrama Jayastvam is also there is gradation in Varna also, gradation in Ashrama also, And there is gradation in jnana and ajnana avastha also. So, what is the sequence? Who should be respecting whom? This is dealt with, we have seen in Vichara Sagra also, in the second adhyaya there. Anyway, so in the context, Siddhante Tat Siddhihi, meaning ashrama definitely, four ashramas are one after the other. If you look at it, then there is definitely hierarchy there and देयरफॉर तत्सिद्धिरिति फलभेदः। उत्तमाश्रमात् पूर्वाश्रम प्राप्तस्य कर्म विद्या हेतुर्वा न वा इति संदेहे। सो व्हेन देयर इज अ डाउट एज टू उत्तमाश्रम एंड पूर्वाश्रम हैज बीन मेंशन्ड ऑलरेडी, सो वन गोज फ्रॉम उत्तमाश्रम टू पूर्वाश्रम, दैट्स व्हाई वी से पूर्वाश्रम। इज देयर वाज देयर अ पूर्वाश्रम फॉर द सन्यासी? यस, वी से पूर्वाश्रम। इन पूर्वाश्रम he was a grihastha, in Purvashrama he had this name, he was a brahmachari, whatever. So he said Purvashrama. So uttamashramat, sannyasashramat, Purvashramam praptasya yatehe, that's the meaning there. So one yati, sannyasi, who has attained Purvashrama after taking sannyasa, uttamashrama, then he'll do some karma. What karma will he do? Whichever ashrama he has returned to, he'll do that karma. So that karma, will it become vidyahetu or not? Will it give rise to Brahmajnana for that yati or not? Who is non-yati now? Who is either a brahmachari or basically grihastha? Here the intention is to say that he has gotten in a relation and either married or he has gotten into a relation. That is the fall. So here there is no intention of talking about brahmacharya. Brahmacharya is being followed by the sannyasi also. It should be followed. So there is no brahmacharya ashram that he can come back to. He can remain in the same ashrama. So why has he... What ashrama has he gone back to? He won't go back to Vanaprastha, because in Vanaprastha upasana is pradhana. That upasana anyway he is doing. Either he is doing Sravana Manididhyasana or within that Nididhyasana itself is upasana also. Some sort of upasana. So he is doing that. If he is interested to do upasana or follow brahmacharya, he can do in the grihastha, yatyashrama or sannyasa ashrama itself. So what is really meant as purvashrama here? Grihastha ashrama. He is interested to get into relations. That's what it means really. So if that is the meaning, then that praptasya karma would be what? Grihastha karma, agnihotradi karma. Will that become vidya hetu or not? Since the Siddhanti has established that all ashrama karma is vidya hetu, with lot of effort, Siddhanti has established that in the earlier adhikarana. So the Purvapakshi says, what is the problem? It is the same karma. Just like you established that the Upanishad Antargata Yajnadi Karma is same as the Yajnadi Karma which is Karma Kanda Antargata, then the same Karma Kanda Antargata Grihastha Karma, Yajni Hotradi Karma, whether it is done by the one who has not taken to the Sannyasa Ashrama or one who has returned from Sannyasa Ashrama to Grihastha Ashrama, where is the difference? So his drishti is that there is no Patitattvam, there is no fall at all, there is no prachyuti. So it is the same karma, grihastha karma, which was leading to Brahma Vidya, will lead to Brahma Vidya whether or not one has come back from sannyasa. This is his perspective, to which the Vidya Hetu iti Purvapaksha, the Siddhanta answer is Vidya Hetu iti Purvapaksha. Same karma, because it is the same karma which is already established as Vidya Hetu, even if one comes back from sannyasa to that karma, even that Agnihotra karma, which is being done now after return from sannyasa, will also become vidyayetu. Why not? To that Siddhanti say, Siddhantastu tad bhutasya, meaning prapta uttamashramasya, one who has attained the highest uttamashrama, yatyashrama, sannyasa ashrama, atad bhavaha, there is no uttamashrama prachyutihi, katham api na sambhavati iti jaiminehe api acharyasya sammatam. It is acceptable even to the karmakandi proper jaimini acharya, the bhagavan sutrakara in karmakanda sutrakara, purvimamsa sutrakara himself says that we do accept there is sannyasa for whatever reasons. For what reasons they accept sannyasa ashrama may differ, but one who has gone to the sannyasa ashrama cannot come back. There is no atad bhava, meaning there is no tad bhava uttama ashramat prachyuti. Atad bhava is tad bhava is sannyasa bhava, and atad bhava is non sannyasa na. So this na of the should be read there, na katham api na sambhavati, atad bhava na sambhavati. In any which manner you argue, it is not going to be acceptable at all, says the Purvamimamsaka Acharya, Jaimini Acharya also. Jaimini he api Acharya se sammatam. So we don't need to establish, you can go and refer to your own Karmakanda Sutras says the Siddhanti to the Puro Pakshi. Api Shabdena, why Api has been mentioned to that? Bhagavan Sadashiv Brahmendra says Api Shabdena Bhagavataha Badarayanasya cha Sammatam Evaiti Darshitam. Anyway, Vedantins, Vyasacharya says that definitely it is not acceptable because Sannyasa Ashrama is taken with Mithyatva Nishchaya for Jnana or after rise of Jnana. So it would be foolish to actually go back into a mithya prapancha, that too where dvaita bhavana is very strong. To physically get into a relation is seeing something as satya at all levels, because the relation, physical relation, involves everything that is at one's disposal. We have seen in Vichara Sagara in detail as to even one indriya can trap particular set of animal. So different indriyas are mentioned for different animals as to how these indriyas are used to trap the animal by the hunters, animals or birds or whatever be it, pashu pakshi. All these five indriyas are in play in a human being, and especially so in a physical relation. So with a physically getting involved, they're all indriyas where shamadama is the basic cause for jnanotpatti. That's where the journey starts. The sannyasi is going back to that itself. How is it not a prachyuti? In fact, it is not a chyuti, it is prachyuti only. Prakarsha chyuti. It is an extreme fall. Therefore, it is nishiddha. And therefore, what api shabdena bhagavata badarayanasya cha sammatam eva. There is absolutely no question about Vedantins agreeing to this, you know, homecoming or what do you say these days, gharavapsi. There is no gharavapsi there. That is the home, that is the ghara. So the ghara is only sannyasa ashrama. Other than that, there is absolutely no return. Kutaha, why so? Iti darshitam. So it is shown. Kutaha, why do you say so? Ask the Purvapakshi to that. Niyama atadrupabhya abhavebhyah. What does it mean? Aranyam iyad iti padam tatuna punareyat iti niyama. So Shruti says what? Aranyam iyad, go to the forest, but aranyam iyad iti padam. So once you attain that state where you have mithyatva nishchaya in the prapancha, purushartha nishchaya is there, moksha itself is the purushartha, and it can be gained only by jnana. One takes to vividisha later. Slowly, krameena also, one goes to upasanas, upasana pradhanya, ashrama, and then from there into sannyasa. So aranyam can include both. But primarily, the focus is to reach sannyasa ashrama. Therefore, tato na punar eyat. One should not return from that sannyasa ashrama iti niyama. There is a rule like that. So you cannot say that na is there, so it is a nisheda. Na punar eyat means what? One should not come back. It's a proper nisheda vakya with a vidhiling used. Eyat is a vidhiling there. Na eyat. Then that is first hetu. Second hetu is a pratyavaroha bodhaka shrutyabhava. And there is no shruti which talks about a return. Atadrupam. So atadrupam is the hetu, second hetu. Which means that there is no shruti which talks about return from sannyasa ashrama. One is a nisheda shruti. So niyama is there. Nishedha niyama is there. So niyama is that there is a nishedha. You should not do that. Then one should follow and go further, not come back. And then for return, is there a shruti? There is no such shruti. So pratyavaroha, to climb down from the ladder of this ashrama, there is no shruti. So shrutya bhava. That is second. So meaning atadrupa niyama, atadrupa abhava. Atadrupa abhava is there, and then that is atadrupam. Then shishtachara abhava. So abhava can be read with atadrupa abhava and shishtachara abhava. Niyama is positive. Positively, there is a nisheda vakya. You can find something that is positive. Positive meaning there is a vakya like that. What is a vakya? Nisheda vakya. Not a vidhi vakya. Then atadrupa is, vidhi vakya is not there. What vidhi vakya? For written. There should be some pramana. There is no vakya for written. So there is no positive vakya for written. Therefore, atadrupam. Then shishtachara abhavascha. Shishtachara also, there is nothing seen as to shishtas coming back from meaning in itihasa, purana ityadi, you don't see that. in Smriti, Itihasa Purana, you don't say. Shishtachara is not mentioned anywhere as to Shishtas follow such thing as to going from any ashrama to any ashrama. That is not appropriate. And their adhara is also not there. They don't respect. Tasmat, therefore what is established? Tasmat, prachyutehe apramanikatvat. This prachyuti fall from sannyasa ashrama is definitely apramanam, apramanikam. There is no pramana for that. One is following one's own whims there. One is guided by raga and or dvesha. So for this there is no place in varnashrama. And yadyad acharati shreshtaha, if these people do that, then others will also follow. Therefore it should not be done. Whatever issues are there, you stay and resolve in that very ashrama. There is nothing as to going back, etc. It's not possible. It should not be done. And therefore, what? Prachyutasya karma na vidya heturiti siddham. Even if he goes back, if he is going back because of raga dvesha, anyway he is not interested in vidya. If he goes back, will it facilitate brahma vidya utpatti, his karma? It won't. Then he will be basically following yathashtachara. Yathashta achara. So he is doing it not for dharma, he is doing it driven by raga due to attachments with the opposite gender. Therefore, this is nishiddha. It is not, it has nothing to do with vidya at all. Let it, let alone that karma becoming vidya hetu. So thereby, this adhikarana is also over. It's a single sutra adhikarana. Next adhikara, next adhikarana is adhikarika adhikarana. Now the Purvapakshi says, yathapuram prachyutasya karma na vidya hetu rityuktam. How you have nicely elaborated and established Yudhi Siddhanti as to the fall of the person will not let his karma, person in sense, the sannyasi who has fallen, his karma will not be vidya hetu. Tatha, similarly what? Another drishtanta. He says that tatha prachyutasyapi krutaprayaschittasya karma na vidya hetu riti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Now he says that this prachyuti is not necessarily only from sannyasa ashrama to grihastha ashrama. There are other kinds of falls also. What kind of fall? A naishtika brahmachari or an upakurvana who is not married. Upakurvana means one who is going to leave the gurukula, who was antevasi for after his upanayana and he was studying Veda. But he wants to get married. Whereas naishtika brahmachari, one who is interested in staying in the ashrama itself, does not want to get married, that person will continue in the gurukula as an antevasi, being within the ashrama, following his sandhyavandana ityadi karma and doing shravana ityadi as a naishtika brahmachari. The upakurvana, who is a snataka, he has taken that ritualistic bath with the permission of the guru, he is going to get married. So that upakurvana, in his upakurvana stage, and naishtika brahmachari, both are taken here. How will they have a fall? They'll have a fall by indulging with the opposite gender. Just like the sannyasi in the earlier. Now, what the Purvapakshi is saying is that in the earlier adhikarana, the way the fall of the sannyasi from the sannyasa ashrama to the grihastha ashrama for the physical relation with the opposite gender made his karma as non-vidya, as not vidya hetu. His karma was not considered as vidya hetu. In fact, it is not even allowed. Now, this person, whether he is a brahmachari or an upakurvana who is not married yet, what if that kind of person in that brahmachari avastha, upakurvana avastha, they indulge in physical relation with the opposite gender, then what about them? They'll also have prachyuti. They have also fallen from their naishtika brahmacharya or the upakurvana who is a brahmachari still. He is not married. So he does not have a license to, he does not have patni, he cannot have physical relation, but he ends up having. Then what about them? They have a prachyuti. From dharmashastra perspective, definitely they have had a fall. So whether their karma, which they are continuing in their brahmacharya ashrama, whether temporary brahmacharya till getting married or naishtika brahmacharya ajivana, their yajnyadi karma और संध्या वंदन इत्यादि नित्य नैमित्तिक करो, विल दैट दोज कर्म बिकम स्टिल रिमेन विद्या हेतु और नॉट? यू हैव एस्टैब्लिश दैट दे आर विद्या हेतु, बट आफ्टर द प्रच्युति विल दे स्टिल रिमेन विद्या हेतु और नॉट? दैट इज ए क्वेश्चन. पूर्व पक्षी सेज दैट कृत प्रायश्चित्तस्य, इवन इफ दे हैव डन दिस प्रच्युतस्य ब्रह्मचारिणः और उपकुर्वाणस्य कृत प्रायश्चित्तस्य, सो कृतः प्रायश्चित कृतं प्रायश्चित्तं कर्म येन येन केन येन प्रच्युतेन ब्रह्मचारी ब्रह्मचारिणा और उपकुर्वाणेन. सो वन हू इज इन द ब्रह्मचर्य आश्रम स्टिल वेदर गेट अबाउट टू गेट मैरिड और हू इज गोइंग टू रिमेन ब्रह्मचारी लाइफ लॉन्ग एंड बिकॉज ऑफ हैविंग अ फॉल ही हैज डन प्रायश्चित्त. प्रायश्चित्त इज रिकमेंडेड इन not recommended, it is a vidhi. So prayaschitta vidhi is there, how to do prayaschitta for that prachyuti, for the fall from brahmacharya ashrama. So whether the karma of one who has done prayaschitta also, not one who has not done prayaschitta, that is not even considered by the purvapakshi. Purvapakshi says that person who has had a fall in brahmacharya ashrama and he has done prayaschitta also, tasya karma na vidya hetuhu iti drishtanta sangatya idamah tatha. So similarly, like the sannyasi's karma also, this brahmachari's karma also, who has had a similar fall due to the reason mentioned, let his karma not be vidya hetu. Just like sannyasi is written into ashrama, his karma after the return into ashrama, his karma, because he is not a sannyasi anymore, ashrama karma, grahastha karma, ashrama karma is not vidya hetu. Similarly, this brahmachari's karma, ashrama karma, who has done prayaschitta for his atonement, for his indulgence, fall from dharma, from his naishthika brahmacharya or the brahmacharya vow of celibacy. So let his karma also not be vidya hetu. This is the drishtanta whereby adhikarika adhikaranam comes up, and this is the first sutra is the purvapaksha. Purvapaksha sutra is nacha adhikarikam api patananumanat tadayogat, nacha adhikarikam api patananumanat tadayogat. So purvapakshi says that his karma, patitasya karma, is not vidya hetu. So he is saying nacha adhikarikam api. What is adhikarikam? Adhikarikam is taddita with adhikara. Adhikara lakshana shashtadhyaya siddham. In the 6th chapter of Purvamimamsa Sutras, this particular section in it, the adhikara lakshana discussion covers this. There it is covered. What is covered? The adhikarikam is covered there. Adhikarikam, adhikar lakshanam. Adhikar lakshana shashtadhyay siddham. What is that? Gardhava alambana rupa prayaschittam. So adhikarikam, how does he gain adhikara in karma and the karma phala? Basically in karma phala, how will he get phala of the karma that he is doing? Yajnyadi karma, the nityanaimitika karma. Initially he was an adhikari with upanayana. After that, when he is doing the karma, he has had a fall. So he has a prachyuti. So with prachyuti anyway, without prayaschitta, he cannot continue. So karma will not give phala because he has had the fall from the brahmacharya ashrama itself. So brahmacharya ashrama, which has allowed him, the upanayana samskara has allowed him to do nitya naimittika karma. And he has had a fall from this ashrama dharma. Therefore, is he that brahmachari anymore? He is not really a brahmachari. Then where does he have adhikara to do brahmachari karma? For that, he has to do prayaschitta to gain back the adhikara. That is discussed in the 6th chapter there, where the prayaschitta is gardhava alambana rupa prayaschitta. So, it is seen as sacrificing a donkey to Nirruti, Nirruti Devata. It is called Nairuttyam. So Nairuttyam, अवकीर्णो अवकीर्णी भवेत् गत्वा ब्रह्मचारी तुयोषितं गर्दवं पशु आलभ्य नैऋत्यं च नैऋत्यं स विशुद्ध्यति. सो द शोधन देर प्रायश्चित कर्म विल गिव शुद्धि एंड ही कैन गेन बैक हिज ब्रह्मचर्य स्टेटस. ब्रह्मचारी धर्म ही कैन फॉलो विच विल गिव रिजल्ट्स मीनिंग परलोक सिद्धि एंड ऑल इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज नैष्ठिक ब्रह्मचारी डूइंग हिज नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्म इट्सेल्फ विल गेट ब्रह्मलोक. नथिंग एल्स इज नीडेड. ही डज नॉट नीड टू डू श्रवण मन निध्यासन टू रीच ब्रह्मलोक. वेर एज दी उपकुर्वाणा कैन गेट मैरिड. Now this Upakurvana who wants to get married has had a fall. He has lost eligibility in Brahmacharya Ashrama also, and even Upakurvanattvam is also gone because this Snataka has lost his phala of this Jnana also. He cannot go and get married because he has had a relation. It's a Prachyuti. So for that the Gardhava Pashum Alabhya, one has to offer this donkey to the Niruta Devata, Niruta Devata. So some karma is mentioned there as to the animal sacrifice is ordained. There may be other meanings also. This is what I could gather. So this is prescribed for whom? For that kind of a brahmachari, whether he is naishtika or non-naishtika, who has had a prachyuti, who has had a fall due to he is deviating from his brahmacharya dharma. Now नच आधिकारिकम अपि पतन अनुमानात तदयोगात इज ऑल्सो सिंगल शब्द देर इट्स अ समास. सो दैट इज ए पदच्छेद. सो आधिकारिकम ऑल्सो इज नॉट देर सेज द पूर्वमीमांसा सूत्र सेज द पूर्वपक्षी. दैट इज व्हाट पूर्वपक्षी से वाई पतन अनुमानात पतन अनुमान बिकॉज ही हैज हैड अ फॉल. सो अधिकार लक्षण षष्टाध्याय सिद्धम गर्धव आलंबन रूप प्रायश्चित्तम. दैट प्रायश्चित्त विच इज रेकमेंडेड देर नॉट रेकमेंडेड इट्स अ विधि प्रायश्चित्त विच इज ऑर्डेन्ड देर फॉर सच तदपि नैष्टिकस्य अवकीर्णिनः न एव अस्ति. इट इज नॉट देर सेज द पूर्वपक्षी. Why? What is his hetu? Patana anumanat tadayogat. He says that there is no such, even if you look at the Purvamimamsa Sutra, where it deal the section, 6th chapter, which deals with the qualification, adhikar lakshana is discussed there, adhikar lakshana. The patana anumana is there. Anumana here is the smriti. So anumana can be considered as smriti. So patana anumana, because there is a smriti that he is considering, which will be quoted in the vritti. We'll see in the vritti as to why he says that such kind of a prayaschitta is not applicable in this case. Tada yogat, because it is inefficient in this case. In this case tada yogat, that prayaschitta is not applicable here at all. Patana anumana, because you see patana by anumana meaning by the smriti vakya. So what is he really saying? We'll see more in the vritti. Atra purvapakshe krita prayaschittasya karmana vidya hetu. The one who has done prayaschitta, krita prayaschitta is a bahuri we saw. So this brahmachari who has done prayaschitta, his karma after prayaschitta also, his karma will not become hetu for brahma vidya utpatti. Siddhanti tad hetu riti phalavita. Siddhanti says that no, the karma done by the brahmachari who was patita and has been refined by prayaschitta karma, his karma will become hetu for brahma vidya because he has regained his status of being brahmachari. Why? Because it is not a mahapataka, says the bhashya there. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it is not mahapataka. There are pancha mahapatakas. This does not fall in mahapataka. So it is an upapataka. It is okay, it is a papa karma, but for papa karma there is a specific prayaschitta which is discussed. So this prayaschitta which is discussed, that prayaschitta is applicable in this case also. Thereby what will happen? Pramada prachyutasya kim prayaschitta mastinava iti sandehe आधिकारिकम अपि अधिकार लक्षण सिद्धम गर्धव आलंबन रूप प्रायश्चितम आधिकारिकम. सो दिस आधिकारिकम इज गर्धव आलंबन रूप प्रायश्चित. द प्रायश्चित कर्म विच इज सीन इन अधिकार लक्षण सिद्धम इन दि अधिकार लक्षण इन दि सिक्स चैप्टर ऑफ पूर्व मीमांसा सूत्रास दिस इज डिस्कस एंड दि प्रायश्चित ऑर्डेन देर इज गर्धव आलंबन रूप. So whether pramada pratyutasya, one who has fallen due to pramada, due to negligence, sheer negligence on his part, he was not alert in his brahmacharya ashrama and he lost it, lost that brahmacharya palana. So whether there is prayaschitta or not, not when there is a doubt like that, adhikarikam api, adhikar lakshana siddham, gardhava alambana rupa prayaschittam adhikarikam, that is what is meant by adhikarikam. So it is established there, so gardhava alambana rupa prayaschitta should be done. Tadapi naishtikasya avikiraninaha naivasti. That kind of prayaschitta is not there even for this, even that kind of prayaschitta is not applicable in this case. For the naishtika brahmachari, there is no such prayaschitta at all, says the Purvapakshi. Kutaha, why? Because patana anumanat, although it is ordained in the Purvamimamsa Sutra, nischaya is done. Still, in smriti, arudho naishtikam dharmam yastu prachyavate punaha prayaschittam na pashyami yena shuddhiyet sa atmaha. Although prayaschitta is discussed, it is not applicable. Why? Because the smriti directly says so, says the Purvapakshi. And what is the smriti? Arudha naishtikam dharmam. Yaha, one who has taken the naishtika brahmacharya. And to what? Prachyavate punaha. And having taken this naishtika brahmacharya vrata, he has had a fall, meaning he has deviated from brahmacharya dharma. Prayaschittam na pashyami, the rishi there says, I don't see a prayaschitta for that. So even if the Purvamimamsa Sutra talks about a prayaschitta, it is not applicable because Smriti says that there is no prayaschitta. Yena prayaschittena shuddhyet, saha atmaha shuddhyet, atmaha. Atmanam hanti iti atmaha. Atmanam meaning there oneself. It is in, it's reflexive. So he has had a moral suicide really. The very thing that he gave up during taking the vrata, just like the sannyasi in the earlier case that we saw in the earlier adhikrana, sannyasi had a fall. So the very thing that he is giving up, I do not want this. He does not want any relations also. Let alone the relation with an opposite gender, physical relation. So having given that up, he has had a moral suicide. So that's what the meaning is for atmaha. So saha atmaha na shuddhyet, yena shuddhyet, saha atmaha yena shuddhyet, tam prayaschittam na pashyami. Prayaschittam would be karma, so neuter. So tat prayaschittam aham na pashyami, says the rishi there in smriti vakya. Iti anivartya pataka shrutyanumapaka smritya tasya prayaschittasya ayogat iti purvapaksha. So purvapakshi says that tadayogat means tasya ayogat, shashti tat purusha samasa, tasya kasya prayaschittasya ayogat. That prayaschitta, although discussed in the sixth chapter, it is not applicable. Why? Because due to smriti. Because of the smriti, which smriti? That smriti, which is what kind of a smriti? Anivartya pataka shruti anumapaka shruti smriti. So that smriti, which is anumapaka, anumapika, being strilinga. What is it anumapika of? It helps you do anumana, and because it is in the smriti, even if you cannot find a shruti, you have to infer the shruti that there was such a shruti which is not traceable right now, but smriti is based on shruti. Therefore, smriti helps you arrive at the shruti through anumana that there was such a shruti. So, shruti kalpana should be done. And what is that shruti? Anivartya pataka, that which is not going to take away this papa of the one who has taken naishtika brahmacharya and has had a fall. Siddhantastu, however, Siddhanti responds by saying that it is not so. Upapurvam api tveke bhava ashanavat taduktam. Upapurvam api tveke bhavam ashanavat taduktam. So Siddhanti says upapurvam. Upapurvam is upa. Padachheda is upapurvam api tu eke bhavam ashanavat taduktam. Taduktam is a. Taduktam can be separate also. Tat and uktam. So tat uktam. That has been said. What has been said? Upapurvam api tveke bhavam. Bhavam manyate. So you have to say manyate. Manyante. Eke is there. So eke is bahuvachana. Eka in bahuvachana. It is a pronoun. So anye. Anye ityarthe. In the anye. That meaning is anye. Other than what has been stated by the Purvapakshi or the Purvapakshis who think in this manner, compared to them, there are others who consider what? Upapurvam. Upapurvam is upa is a upapada, upa upasarga, upapada. So upapurvam means what? Pataka. That pataka is not mahapataka. They consider this as upapataka. It is minor compared to the Mahapatakas. For Mahapatakas, there is no Panchamahapatakas, there is no Prayaschitta at all. So even if the Smriti says it is Ninda Rupa, it says that one has to be alert. So Pramado Vai Mrityuhu, elsewhere it says Pramado Vai Mrityuhu. So one should not have Pramada because it is equivalent to Mrityu. So with that you have to consider that the Smriti which says Prayaschittam Na Pashyami, it is Ninda Rupa, meaning one should be very, very alert. It is warning the brahmachari, be alert, you have no prayaschitta if you have a fall. So think over before taking brahmachari vrata. Just like taking before taking sannyasa, you think a lot. There is no way out. You cannot come back. You cannot take sannyasa on the whims. So similarly, naishtika brahmacharya also, you cannot take this brahmachari vrata while not get married and take brahmachari vrata like Bhishma Pratijna. You cannot do that and have a fall. If you are not alert, if you are negligent, then it is possible that you will make a mistake, and having lost brahmacharya, then there is no prayaschitta. This is a warning. This is a to scare away the brahmachari into either not taking naishtika brahmacharya as his path or being very alert. Should be very alert having taken this, meaning shama, dama, ityadi should be continuous. One cannot indulge even a little bit. So this is the reasoning which will be explained in the vritti. So upapurvam means upapataka. They consider this as upapataka, eke, anye. So anye, nishiddha ashanavat. Example is nishiddha ashanavat. Like eating something which is nishiddha. So eating something nishiddha is not a Mahapataka. It is an upapataka. So prayaschitta bhavam means prayaschitta bhavam manyante. Eke manyante. Eke tu manyante. On the other hand, there are some who agree that this is upapurvam patakam. Means upapataka. It is a minor sin in comparison to pancha mahapataka. Meaning it is not mahapataka. Upapataka means it is a pataka, but it is not mahapataka. It does not mean that it is nothing, it's next to nothing. That is not the meaning. It is only, upa is only to differentiate from maha. So it is not mahapataka, it is a pataka. It is a papa, but it is not mahapapa, whereby there is no prayaschitta. So there is prayaschitta, the same prayaschitta which is discussed in the 6th chapter of Purvamimamsa Sutra. Gardhava pashum alabhya nairatyam savishudhyati is applicable there. And one will regain the status of brahmachari. So that is the sutra tata duktam. It has been stated, we'll see more in the vritti. So nedam mahapatakam, idam mahapatakam na nasti na bhavati. So what is it then? Yena prayaschittam na syat. So yena prayaschittam na syat is saying that possibility, shakyarthe ling here. As to had it been Mahapataka, then you could have said, you the Purvapakshi could have claimed that there is no Prayaschitta. Even that Smriti could have been taken literally then. But it is not महापातक देन व्हाट इज इट अपितु एके आचार्यः एके आचार्यः अन्य आचार्यः उपपदम उपपद पूर्वम एव इदं पातकं मन्यते मन्यन्ते सो आचार्यः एके आचार्य अन्य आचार्य मन्यन्ते दे कंसीडर अदर आचार्यस कंसीडर पूर्वमीमांसक आचार्य आल्सो वेदांती आचार्य आल्सो उत्तरमीमांसक आचार्य आल्सो कंसीडर व्हाट दे कंसीडर दिस पातक पातक एज व्हाट दिस पाप एज उपपद पूर्वम एव इदम दिस काइंड ऑफ अ प्रच्युति द पाप पातक दे कंसीडर उपपद पूर्वम उपपातकम दे कंसीडर इट हैज a lesser degree of papa than mahapataka mahapapa ataha therefore what ataha upakurvanasya iva naishtikasya api ukta prayaschitta sadbhavam icchanti now there's a differentiation done this upakurvana is one who is not interested in continuing brahmacharya he is the one who has already had the snataka karma and he is ready to get married so he is looking for a bride Now, if he has a fall, then he has a prayaschitta. He can follow this prayaschitta, which is ordained in the 6th chapter. This is the perspective of the Purvapakshi. Now, this he says that naishtika brahmachari doi, he wants to remain in brahmacharya. One who wants to get married may have a fall. And then, anyway, he is going to get married. So, he is not focused on maintaining his brahmacharya, so he may lose it. And thereby, if he has lost brahmacharya, then let him do prayaschitta and gain back his status of as an eligible bachelor, ready to get married. But naishtika can't do that because he has focus in brahmacharya ashram itself. He is saying that he is not interested in physical relations. He is not going to get married. Anyway, that marriage should be for karma. That is what the dharma shastra says. But then. Having gotten married, begetting children and all, that is there. And even the Shruti also, the Dharma Shastra also gives a 6 month or I think 6 month or 1 year, some kind of a honeymoon period rather, whereby this the couple is allowed to not maintain the Agnihotra adi ityadi karma. So the Nitya karma, Agnihotra karma, which should be done after marriage, So, it gives some concession saying that you have gotten into a married life. So, you understand each other. You take time, have this honeymoon period and then you continue the karma. So, such kind of a concession is given whereby this Upakurvana is looking forward to a relation as well. So, he may have a fall. Naishtika should not, says the Purvapakshi. This is his Abhipraya there. So, Ukta Prayaschitta Sadbhavam Icchanti. Ataha Ukta Prayaschitta Sadbhavam. So, Bhavam is Sadbhavam. Kidrsha Sadbhavam Ukta Prayaschitta Sadbhavam. Yes, there is a solution in the form of the Prayaschitta which has already been stated. Taduktam Kutra Uktam Purvamimamsa Sutreshu Eva Uktam. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. Whatever solution as Prayaschitta has been inquired into, has been analyzed, Mimamsa has been done at great length, which is the expert area of the Purvamimamsaka, we are not stepping into that. It has already been done. So, we just extend it to Naishtika Brahmachari also. And thereby what? Ubhayo Brahmacharitve Sati Avakiranatva Avisheshat. There is absolutely no difference between the kind of fall that the Upakurvana has, whereby he has become Avakirana. So avakiranitvam that he has attained is the same avakiranitvam that naishtika will also attain by a similar fall. Therefore, there is no different avishesha is there. Both have had a similar prachyuti. Therefore, the way ashanavat nishiddha ashana is there. Yatha brahmacharinaha madumamsashinaha vratalopaha punaha samskarascha tadvat. So, another example is given. If this Upakurvana or Naishtika Brahmachari, if they do Madhupana, drink liquor or eat Mausa, which is Nishiddha, Brahmachari should not be, Brahmachari in fact in any, from any of the three Varnas should not be consuming Mausa. Madhu also definitely, liquor is Nishiddha. So, if they have had nishiddha ashana, nishiddha, they have partaken, they have eaten, then this for the brahmachari, vratalopa has taken place. He has taken brahmachari vrata, and madhumamsa ashana is also nishiddha for him. It will take away his vrata. So puna samskarascha, there is prayaschitta for that, and samskara is there tadvata. Tasmat prayaschitta sadbhav yuktatara. I'll just finish these two lines. Tasmat prayaschitta sadbhav yuktatara. Therefore, it is definitely very logical to say that prayaschitta is there. Just like nishiddha asana, there is prayaschitta which is there for upakuruvana. Similarly, the same prayaschitta is applicable to the naishtika brahmacharya. Staduktam, it has been said. Where has it been stated? Pramana lakshane, in the 6th chapter of Purvamimamsa Sutra, Pramana Lakshane, what has been said? Samavipratipattisyat. Then next sutra says, Shastrasthava tan nimittatvat. So Jaimini Sutra 138 and 139. 138 is a, it's a Purvapaksha. Samavipratipattisyat. So this Vrihirva, Yavirva, Yajeta, ityatra vikalpa, there is a vikalpa there. In this case, there is no such vikalpa. So Samavipratipattisyat. So, is there an option out, one for Upakurvana, another for Naishtika Brahmachari? There is no such division possible there. Therefore, Atra Prakrutetuna Sambhavati. Therefore, the answer is given in this sutra. This is how we are seeing the meaning. Shastrasthava Tannimittatvat. So, whatever the Shastra says, that will hold good. So, when there is Vikalpa is not there, then whatever is the Shastrartha, which has decided, this is the Shastra's opinion, Shastrastaha, whatever prayaschitta is there, that will become nimitta, tan nimittatvat, and thereby the same solution which is applicable in the case of Upakurvana will be applicable in the case of Naishtika Brahmachari also. Iti prayaschitta abhava smaranam tu. Then Purvapakshi says, what about this smriti that I have quoted? What about that smriti? Smriti is arudo naishtikam dharma yastu pratyavate punaha. Prayaschittam na pashyami yena shuddhye sa atmaha. What about that? So to that, Siddhanti says, prayaschitta, we have seen this, so I'll speed through. Prayaschitta abhava smaranam tu. In the smriti, the smarana of this prayaschitta abhava is for what purpose? To yatna gauravartham iti vyakhyatavyam. It should be understood as it is for yatna gaurava. Prayatna should be a lot to remain brahmachari. It is not easy to be a brahmachari. Be warned. This is, so beware, it is a warning sign. Before you enter, be careful as to what are your options. There are no options, you just have to go ahead. There is no return at all. And there is no deviation to a different ashrama also. Iti vyakhyatavyam. Itham vanaprastasya mahakakshabhi vardhanam prayaschittam yatestu swashastra samskarati dhyayam. Now the question is, okay, for the Upakurvana and Naishtika Brahmachari, same solution is there. Grahastha does not need a solution because Grahastha is allowed to have physical relations with his Patni. Then the remaining two ashramas, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa, what about that? What about Vanaprastha if he has a fall? Because Vanaprastha has given Grahastha ashrama, he cannot be indulging in relations anymore, in physical relation. And Sannyasi, definitely he is not allowed, that has already been established. So itham, in this manner, there is prayaschitta for the others also. What is the prayaschitta? Vanaprastasya mahakakshabhi vardhanam prayaschittam. For the Vanaprastha, if he has a physical relation, after taking to the Vanaprastha, where he has given up the grahastha's behavior, then mahakakshabhi vardhanam. He should, kind of a forest area where, you know, a lot of grass or soma ityadi is there. Soma is primary there. So he should make sure that soma, creepers, etc., they grow. He should dharbha, whatever is used for yaga, he should build a mini forest out of it, and so long he should just keep on doing that. That is one. Yatestu swashastra samskarati dhyayam. Whereas yati, if the sannyasi has a fall, there is a prayaschitta for that also. What is the prayaschitta? Swashastra samskara. Whatever has been ordained in the for the yati, that should be there. But Bhagavan Bhashyakara elaborates on this. So he should do whatever the Vanaprastha is doing. So Vanaprastha वानप्रस्थो दीक्षा भेदे कृच्छ्रम द्वादशरात्रम चरित्वा महाकक्षम वर्धयेत. सो हियर ओनली वन अभिवर्धन ऑफ द महाकक्षा हैज बीन मेंशन, बट भगवान भाष्यकार कोट्स दी धर्मशास्त्र. ही सेज वानप्रस्थ दीक्षा भेदे सति किं कर्तव्यं तेन वानप्रस्थेन. सो देर द्वादशरात्रम कृच्छ्रम चरित्वा बिफोर ही डज महाकक्षा अभिवर्धन ही हैज टू डू कृच्छ्र प्रायश्चित फॉर 12 नाइट्स. सो द सन्यासी शुड डू ऑल दैट एंड आफ्टर डूइंग दैट व्हाट शुड द वानप्रस्थ डू? वानप्रस्थ शुड डू महाकक्ष वर्धन. सो शुड द अभिवर्धन ऑफ महाकक्ष शुड द सन्यासी ऑल्सो डू दैट? सो फॉर दैट भिक्षु वानप्रस्थ वत सोमवल्ली वर्जम. सो ही शुड नॉट ही शुड ऑल्सो ग्रो द फॉरेस्ट इन यू नो द फार्म देर where there is whatever has to be used in the whatever is used in the dharma karya karma. So such things can be grown, darbha etc. A lot of it has to be grown, but somavalli varja. So somavalli should not be planted or grown by the sannyasi, but other than that his vrata he should continue by doing this prayaschitta of krichra for 12 nights etc. swashastra samskarasya and whatever japa ityadi prescribed for the sannyasa ashrama he should continue that om ityadi om pranava ityadi iti evamadi prayaschitta smaranam. All this is mentioned in the smriti as quoted in the bhashya iti dheyam. This should be understood. So let's stop here. Sorry for the overshoot of 10 minutes. Amna yantik samsiddham adi madhyant varjitam ananda ghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasmahe namaste. Dhanyavada.